Grazie Federico. Noi abbiamo un tempo necessario entro cui finire, però Wolfgang Kowalsky dovrà andare via prima. Quindi io cambierei un attimo la scaletta, per cui dare la parola di nuovo ai relatori che hanno anche già parlato, e chiederei a Wolfgang Kowalsky se vuole intervenire adesso.
Yes, thanks a lot for inviting me to this important meeting. I'm working at ETUC on the information consultation on participation issues. So I was asked to have a look on the question of supply chains on these instruments we have. This comes at the right moment because the ETUC just decided last month to launch a campaign in favor of better rights for workers on information consultation and participation. Because we are confronted to a very strange situation at European level, since more than a decade we didn't make any progress at all. The Commission published a social pillar, but there was nothing on information consultation and participation. The Commission will publish tomorrow the new package on company law and company mobility. And the objective of the Commission is to facilitate company mobility. They will have three new instruments, new and old instruments, facilitate transfer of seat, which is easy, and which is quite linked to the issue of supply chain. Second, they want to revise the mergers directive. And third, they want to add a new instrument for facilitating divisions in companies. And this is quite dangerous because we have a few instruments. We have no, as Julian said beforehand, we have no clear instrument for controlling supply chain, but we have some instrument from different sides. And if we put it together like a spider net, we can have some influence on this. Amongst those instruments are the information consultation tools. There are, I would say, I simplify a little bit, four. The first is the framework directive on information consultation at national level. So in different member states, either you have works councils or you have other bodies to inform and consult workers. The rights are somewhat different from one country to the other, but at least there is a this has to be established in all countries since 2002. But what is missing, and the ETUC a few years ago asked for a revision of the directive, and we wanted to have a better directive. And we said information consultation must cover the value chain, upstream suppliers, subcontractors, dependent companies downstream. So we recognized there is a loophole, and we said to the Commission something must be done. Unfortunately, the Commission didn't answer. They did a fitness check, and they simply said, okay, all the directives are fit for purpose. We said, no, they are old directives, they must be updated. They must also be fit to see what's happening in the value chain, because it doesn't help. Inside the company, trade unions are strong. We can make sure there are good working conditions, everything is respected. It's a sustainable company, respecting the standards. And then they outsource a part somewhere else in the world, and we have no control. Nevertheless, as we said before, we have to use these instruments. In the meetings of the works councils or the workers' representation body, we can ask for these information. We don't always get an answer, but in some companies we get answers and we can exert pressure so that the rules are applied along the whole value chain. Second, we have in big companies European works councils. Companies up to 1,000, we have European works councils. We have more or less the same rights, information for consultation. We have the same situation, more rights to control the value chain. But a year ago, the ETUC asked for a revision of the EWC directive as well. Unfortunately, the Commission said picture, no answer. The Commission told us they have to analyze how it works. And since 2016, that's written down in the directive, they should come up with an assessment. They said first in the end of 2016, then they made the play beginning 2017, end of 2017. Now they told us this month it will be published, but after so many promises not kept, we are skeptical, but one day they will publish it. And, but we know already there are a lot of loopholes in the directive to say only one. 40% of the EWC works, EWCs don't correspond to the directive. They were created before the directive came into place, and they can continue. Our colleagues in these EWC have the problem. They can say we stop this agreement, but in the directive it isn't said that during the renegotiation time, and that can take 1 year, that can take 2 years, it depends upon the company when they agree, there will be no works councils at all. So a lot of our colleagues say, okay, better work with a bad EWC than with no EWC at all. We told the Commission, and the Commission said, okay, we will check and see what will be the outcome. The third instrument we have in 18 member states out of 28 is representation of workers in company boardrooms. For us, this is a very important tool because in the boardrooms you get the same information, the complete information as the shareholders. In most of the countries, we have a third of the workers in the boardrooms, so we never, and in some systems we have half of them, but we never have the majority. So in the end, it's always the management and the owners who can decide. But we have the situation that we can ask all the questions, also about the supply chain. And in this room, they have to answer. But then comes the confidentiality. We have to pay attention because they will declare this is confidential because it is on our business model. It is everything which is related to the commercial situation can be declared confidential. And for them, if they can find a company or subcontractor which is cheaper, and this is part of the business model, they can oblige our people not to say too much. Okay, we try nevertheless to inform at least the trade union colleagues in general, EWC members, but this makes our life somewhat difficult. So we ask that there should be strict rules on what can be declared confidential, because it's too easy for the company can give us all the information and then they simply just say it's confidential, that can't be accepted. First, we want to know until when it's confidential, because if the company comes up with a new product, they know when it will come up, and they can declare until then it's confidential. But on working conditions and the supply chain, I don't know why this should be confidential. So that's also part of the spider web we have to spin to get this information. We have, as you see now, very clear demands, but the problem is the Commission doesn't listen. And in the Parliament, when we make publicity for our demands, we have more than 750 members of Parliament. But there are very few understanding trade union language and taking the initiative to help us. So we are now at a good moment. That's why we started this campaign. We have to make clearer what is our aim why do we need more information, consultation, participation for workers? What does it mean in clear language, avoiding slogans, jargon, avoiding abbreviations? I was asked in a public meeting, what is EWC? Is it new water closet? So I understood, okay, even that is too much jargon. There are people who don't understand this, so we have to explain every time what it is about to create a better condition that the next commission can't escape because we have enough support in the European Parliament. And this is linked also to next year in May. On one side, the EPC has won, but there will be also EP elections. And it's important to make a campaign that we have enough colleagues in the Italians supposed to pay attention, but there are a lot of others who don't pay enough attention. When we ask them, can you give us a few names? We don't get much. But this is important. It's not necessary that we get the majority in the Parliament. No. In the past, it succeeded to have a group of 50, 60 people, which is critical mass to help us to push the Parliament in the right direction. So we are ambitious, but not as, it's not impossible. We don't ask for the impossible. And so this is quite important so that we can really improve the situation. And I would like to finish and say a few words also on standards. It's quite important. Guido had mentioned it, there's one standard, TCO, which is a standard developed by trade unions. So most of the computers have TCO standards, and only few people know what it means. So Guido will in future organize a meeting to invite the director from our Swedish colleagues to deal with this. And we want this multiplied much more in Europe. We need more standards. We mentioned standards for workers. We can imagine a lot. We are all traveling a lot, and we would respect such a standard, and that would create a critical mass to change also for the better. And short comment, you mentioned the non-financial reporting. There is now, just now, ongoing a commission consultation on public reporting by companies. And I would encourage you, we sent out an email to invite you to participate in the consultation. And you should stress there is a loophole on the supply chain and there must be more done. And I think when many trade unions, and perhaps they also colleagues from the standardization body, answer to this and say all the same, this is a new loophole which is used, and we want to close it, then the Commission might be more open to change this as well. And we have some time. The consultation goes on until 21st of July, so it's not tomorrow or the day after we have to do that. And for our Democracy of Work campaign, we are just launching an European appeal, which should be published on Europe Day, which is the 9th of May. And for this, we look for signatures from Secretary Generals, trade unions. We sent it out not even a week ago. We already have 15, but we have 89 member organizations and all the organizations, so we should get much more, and we would be extremely thankful if you could help as well. And the last point on digitalization, you had it in this morning, but I think sometimes we have a quite skeptical view on it, but there are some things happening which go in the right direction. For the first time, we have in some online platforms established works councils, Cologne, in Vienna. And thanks to my colleague sitting here, your Stefania reported back this morning. For the very first time, we succeeded to get half parity in the supervisory board in one of these platforms. And there, that's the place where all the company decisions are made. So we can tell them, even if they don't listen because we don't have the majority, but we can push them in the directive, in the direction to make fair wages, to respect minimum standards, to have good working conditions. And I think this is a major breakthrough. We shouldn't underestimate it. And this is linked to a few other events in recent times, which perhaps put some of the big players more on the defensive. You all followed the scandal of Facebook, 87 million data of persons stolen. Until now, I haven't seen that they changed the business model. The business model continues to be the same. Collect all data available, even if you're not on Facebook, your data can be collected by these as well as by Google. But at least they are now on the defensive. I've seen in big newspapers, they're in publicity for the European Data Protection Regulation. What an irony. They fought against it. Now they ask us all who are on Facebook to accept the new rules of procedure. But we should wait a little bit before we accept it. Because there will be a better offer later. We will see. And last but not least, the most disruptive company, Uber, which has had the objective to get rid of competitors, not respect labor law, not respect employment conditions. Now they are also on the defensive. They promised to have less accidents. And now a self-driving car by Uber killed a person. So what's the promise and what is the reality? And a lot of US member states now said, stop the public testing. This is too dangerous. That's what they should have done from the beginning. Now that takes back, it's more like Europe, we are more cautious, we do it on test terrains, but not in public. First, we have to make sure that these cars are not add to the much too high figure of accidents. Okay, so I think it's quite important the work we are doing, and we should consider it as a spider net where we get more and more grip on what is happening in the companies and to close all these loopholes. And we have some instruments which must be improved, but we have to use them all, even if they are different from one country to the other. Okay, if there are any questions, I still have a quarter of an hour and I can listen to it. Thanks for your attention.
Grazie. una specie di ricetta che dà una salute di sonnette quando si pensate le loro linee di vita per l'incontro di un'ultima storia e la signora è stata individuata nel momento in quella di fornitura ma in quella di distribuzione io credo che la vista di sonnette di aspetto di fare con questa mi ha fatto molto importante alle loro linee di vita e alla possibilità di affrontare la risoluzione. Questo. 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 Questo.